What a nice boy Maddie is, huh?
Caring for Maddie can be overwhelming. The 17-year-old needs constant care.
Oftentimes, it's relaxing for me to go to work. Home is demanding.
Physically demanding, emotionally exhausting, and overwhelmingly expensive.
It never ends. It's a 24/7 job, and it really is something that you have to be determined to balance your emotions and shut it off sometimes, because he requires a lot of care, a lot of care.
Adam needs less care. He has high-functioning Asperger's and is in a regular classroom, but the 11-year-old still needs services.
I get upset if things aren't right.
Like, what happens when you get upset?
I get very frustrated and start to cry.
Services help people like Adam deal with the things in life that trigger problems, but those services cost money. When it comes to cash, Governor Rendell says Pennsylvania is ahead of other states. In his term as governor, the Commonwealth went from zero funding for autism to $20 million. He says that funding will actually save taxpayers money in the long run.
If we get a two-year-old and are able to diagnose a two-year-old with autism, studies have shown that we can avoid $1.9 million of cost in supportive services by doing that early diagnosis.
And the governor is backed up by research being done here in Pittsburgh.
Even though many children with autism are not going to be cured, if at least we start early, engaging them in social interaction and communication and trying to build in language skills and play skills, that symptoms will be less severe.
While services fight for more funding, researchers are studying new ways to help those like Adam handle social situations better. Take, for instance, his conversation when he went to a cookout at Ben Roethlisberger's house.
You know, he'll walk right up to him and just start asking him about the windows in the top of his house. You know, all the other kids are kind of staring, going, oh, it's Ben Roethlisberger. My son will walk right up to him, hey, how do you clean those windows up there in the... And, you know, Ben's like, yeah, I don't do it. You know, it's somebody else does it.
I'm just not that into football.
Research being done here in Pittsburgh might help Adam learn to relate to people better. UPMC demonstrated this device, which tracks eye movement. The red dots show where my eyes are focusing to understand the person's emotion, the eyes, the mouth. A person with autism often doesn't know where to look and gets confused in social situations.
So their actual way of gathering information on something we don't even think about,
right,
how we tell emotions, is different.
Okay.
But Dr. Strauss's research is finding ways to teach that skill, because communication is vital for those with high-functioning Asperger's to hold a job, become independent, and wean themselves off of government assistance.